competition looking steep. And I'm training, I've been focused, I've been bombing from the deep. I'm like, move the chains, I'm about to make a play. Move the chains, tell them get about the way. Move the chains, I'm about to win the game. Move the chains, baby, tell them move the chains. Move the needle for the city like the championships. All my records go hard, this a champion hit. I've been working for this moment like I've been in the gym. Jumping all over hurdles, I'm evading the pit. Anybody take them, I can shake them. I invite them to the fire, then I bake them. I'ma break them. I'm a Hall of Fame legend. They should go and hang my jersey. Made to put in work, I don't think they really heard me. Like, move the chains, I'm about to make a play. Move the chains, tell them get about the way. Move the chains, I'm about to win the game. Move the chains, baby, tell them move the chains. Ain't no stopping me, ain't no topping me. I am up. Number one seed, ain't nobody popping up. Got a squad of gorillas from the jungle suited up. You kicking off against me, hope you ready, get it up. I be booted up, popping out a sprinter or a truck. Whole team.
The NFL is on EA Sports, and we're at Raymond James Stadium in Tampa, Florida, with the
They react and play it back on the camera. Hot boy, just consider me flammable. Sure shot, I got all the intangibles. Need a leash, I'm a beast, I'm an animal. Heat the competition up like a Hannibal. Know the game like I wrote up the manual. I do weekly what you do on the annual. MVP, that decision unanimous. Big dogs, I don't think they can handle it. Battlefield, it's just me and my warriors. Guaranteed we emerging victorious. Years blessed, sweat, tears, it's glorious. I remember when they all was ignoring us.
Dash, got it on, smash, foot on the gas.
The NFL is on EA Sports, and we're at Raymond James Stadium in Tampa, Florida. Just a short time ago, the Buccaneers emerging from their tunnel to the roar of this frenzied crowd here in the Sunshine State. And we're in the big ship, and fittingly, everyone here ready to do battle as Tampa Bay gets ready to match up with the Dallas Cowboys. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Now the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. 11 yards and a Cowboy first down. A tough run by Ezekiel Elliott, the fourth overall pick in the 2016 draft.
If you watch tape of him in college, you saw plenty of those runs because I know the highlights showed him in the open field breaking away from people, but that's how he wore down defenses, those exact type of runs.
The first down carried by Elliott doesn't amount to much as he'll get forward for about a couple. On second down, Elliott. It'll go as a gain of 7 on the play, and it sets up a third and inches situation.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Third and short yardage. Prescott got an open man, the tight end Jarwin. And he's got a first down as he's up to the 48. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs. A first down carry by Elliott. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 13 yards and a first down, Cowboys.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid game.
7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3. So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. The first carry now for Tony Pollard.
And he's got room. And they move this all the way down to the 9. Good yardage as he rumbles for 24 and a first. They've taken this opening kickoff and marched it right down the field defensively. Not much resistance.
And that's the point, because my admiration is for the guys moving the ball right now. They know what they're doing. Their plan is working. But I flip it over and watch and say, okay, what are you going to do to change things up? Because if you don't, they're going to put that ball in the end zone real soon.
Pollard going to try the right side. After getting stuffed on first down, not much better there. 2-yard gain. This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on third and goal? On third down, it's Pollard. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. 6 yards puts him right on the doorstep, but now it'll be fourth and goal. And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth.
56.
They'll run it with Elliott. And he will take it in for a Cowboy score. Ezekiel Elliott taking it in. And the Cowboys take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. Forbath able to convert the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This is taken at his 4. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. So first and 10 now from the 30.
Push him easy, easy, easy. Push him back. Follow. Mike 54. No gain.
From the gun, Winston. Well, he's going to take a shot right away. And that is incomplete. Showed off the arm strength there, but to no avail. Second down. Ball on the 30 as they come up second and 10.
Big series right here, so we got to step it up.
Now Winston. There's the Penn State man. It's Chris Godwin. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. First down, Winston. He sets up the screen to Jones. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. That's going to go as a loss of 1 on first down. Got to give some credit there defensively. They snuffed out that screen early on first down.
Really read it well, didn't they? Because they didn't bring the pressure that they expected. They covered all the passing lanes. So once you see it break down as the passer, I think in this situation, you're throwing it at the feet of your back to make sure no one picks it off, or you throw it away, throw it over the sideline. Don't try and freelance and try and make a bigger play. There's really no one else running a pattern that should be open.
Winston connecting with Howard. It's a gain of 16, first down Tampa Bay. And forget about the run to set up the pass. They're just coming out throwing.
Forget trying to set anything up. They feel like they have the advantage. They feel like they have the matchups, and they're just attacking right now.
Yep, going to the air on the opening drive. Now a play fake here on first down. Steps away to his left. Got a man. It's Breshon Perriman.
And that's why you do all the drills that you do from the quarterback position, because you're not going to just throw to your strength. The right-handed quarterback naturally will want to move to the right side to throw the football. But sometimes you've got to go left, and that's exactly what happened on that play. Forced to his left, still able to accurately throw it downfield for a completion.
On second down, it's Jones. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. That's good for a Buccaneer first, a pickup of 12 yards.
Some big plays in the passing game on this drive, and here's one out of the running game. So the passing game loosening things up. Now there's room to roam.
After the run by Jones, here's first and 10.
Let's go, defense. Let's go, defense. Oh, here we go.
And that one covered beautifully. Their defender stayed home, and they'll stop him behind the line. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. That loss of 3, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's second and 13. Winston now. Looking for Perriman there. He's got him. A good pickup there, 21 yards. They're piecing together a nice drive to start this one. Seems pretty scripted and pretty successful so far.
And I think they did it without our help. Because you remember when we sat in the production meeting with them to talk about this and, hey, you know, how are you guys going to come out of the gate? I know I offered my help with a few plays, and they didn't seem to want
offer mine.
You know, you were the smart one. Whatever they're doing, though, it's working really well.
Fans, a reminder, I have a note card here that says ad-lib halftime previews, so I guess let's do just that as we'll hand things over to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando when this one reaches halftime. Did I do okay?
You did great. Not a bad job.
Hey.
But, you know, writing down your ad-libs.
If you print it, I'm going to read it. I'm Brandon Gaudin. This defense hasn't let him in yet. They'll need to... And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Taking it in from 2 yards out as they are now on the board here in the first half. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And we are tied at 7. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. This is taken at his 4. And he'll take this one near the 25. Call it the 26-yard line.
Let's go.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense getting the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3-and-out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. Call a no gain that time as it's going to leave them with a 3rd and about 3 to go. Prescott from the gun on 3rd. And a throw there going to be incomplete. More problems here on 3rd down. They've converted only once so far in this first half.
And you know as well as I do in this league, if you don't win on 3rd down, it makes it hard to win a ball game because then you're relying on your defense, you're relying on your special teams. You've got to get it done with your offensive unit.
Now the offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on 4th and 3. They're indeed going for it. It's Prescott. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. JPP cruising in for the sack that time. So they take a big, big chance here in their own territory. And you think the coach may have some questions to answer?
Yeah, and, you know, normally we focus on the media, right? The social media barrage that he's going to get for this one. How about on his own sideline and in his locker room? Because I think the team's going to look at him like, coach, why would we go for it there? I mean, no confidence in the defense. You don't like the punter. I mean, what's going on here? You owe us some explanations.
2nd and 10 now from the 27. Throwing, Winston. Buying time to his left. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Winston needing a big play after the sack as he leads the Bucs up on 3rd and long. Play action now, Winston. This into the hands of his running back, Ronald Jones. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and that'll bring up fourth down. So on fourth down, on comes the Buccaneer kicker, Matt Gay. From the right hash, it's a 38-yard attempt. And Gay knocks this one through. And that will do it for this first half. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down, two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. The Bucs with a lead, and they'll get the football first as the second half is underway. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
From the 27, Winston. He goes full extension, and he's got it.
Maximum effort, partner. Minimal gain.
Yeah, minimal gain. Looked good, though. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. From the shotgun, it's Winston. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And unable to connect. Incomplete. Now give him credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
Well, this at least is the right idea. I think they've got to get the tight end more involved.
He had just one target in the first half, incomplete. Now incomplete here with the first target of the second half.
Yeah, should not stop them at all from going back to him, though. Find him. Find him.
5 on 50. On fourth down, they do snap it to Winston. He's got Evans. 17 yards on the play and a Buccaneer first down.
Partner, this is one of the best routes anyone can have in their offensive playbook. Tough to defend because you think it's a go route, and then he breaks it back on the comeback. There's one other thing you need as well.
A well-thrown ball.
Exactly right. Gav, a guy who has some precision in throwing the football because of the timing of the route.
Escaping the pressure right. And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football, and he's taken down. Jalen Smith just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7. Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. To throw is Winston. Into double coverage and it's intercepted. Picked off, Byron Jones. Well, let's get back to the playoff picture. We talked about the AFC. Let's look at the NFC. That race starting to come into focus. We know most of the teams, Seahawks, 49ers, Saints, and Packers all in. Vikings in good shape. How do you handicap this race? It seems like anyone can beat anyone.
I think you're spot on because if you were going into the playoffs with these teams that we're going to talk about, who would you make the absolute favorite? It could be anyone, right? It could be Seattle. It could be San Francisco. It could be New Orleans. I know Minnesota's probably going to come in as a wild card. Green Bay will come in as a division champ, it looks like. But bottom line is, Dallas or Philadelphia's got to win the NFC East. And I don't know that anyone wants to go to their home field and play when they have to play in a divisional game. So when it comes, when you get it all together, and maybe that would be a wild card, I would guess, because they'd be the fourth team in. But when you put it all together, it is absolutely wide open about who wins the NFC and represents for the Lombardi Trophy.
A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. Prescott on first down. stepping up. He'll try and run. He'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down.
Now, how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
Looking to throw again on second down. Prescott. And he's going to be swallowed up. Sacked back at the 45-yard line. Shaquille Barrett. What a play by him. That's going to go as a loss of 13. They'll need a big play here. Will Dak and the Cowboys after the sack. It's third and long. Prescott from the gun. And he'll hit the slant route. That's caught by Cooper. They wind up getting 16, but even that's not quite enough. It's fourth down. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Prescott to throw on third. He's got his target. It's Cobb. And he lost the football. And the Buccaneers have it. And they're going to come up empty here on fourth down. Well, he did what he's known for. He made the catch, then he turned into a runner, took the contact, and coughed it up.
And all I remember as a player, when they catch the ball, when those acrobatic guys catch it, you have to make them pay sometimes. You have to put it on them, big tackle, knock the ball free, anything you can do to slow them down.
Brings up second and seven. Ready, at the 16-yard line. Get away
with it. Again, it's Jones. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down. One of the bigger plays in the game thus far, and the crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. To throw, Winston. Flushed out right. And that will be incomplete. Critical play in this football game because if they pick up the first there, that clock keeps rolling.
Has to be a little frustrating for them because they know that if they pick up a first down there and continue to eat away at the clock, really increases their chances of closing this one out. Now they're likely going to have to give the football up and sweat it out on the sideline.
The Bucs go for it. It's Winston. And he is caught. It's Perriman. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. They go for it on fourth down, and it pays off big time as they pick up 29. Winston now 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's first and 10. Now Winston. And he finds Howard complete.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is. And they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys' 32-yard line.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down, stomped down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Rashad Perriman. 32 yards as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. Extra point by Gay is up and good, and his guys will take a 10-point lead. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And last time the turnover on the fumble, and they were in enemy territory, so that had to be very frustrating. Down on the scoreboard here, can't do it again.
You nailed every part of what was frustrating. Down on the scoreboard, had a drive going, had pushed it past the 50-yard line, so they felt like they were in striking distance, and to come away with nothing, not a good feeling at all, to put it mildly. Now they can't afford to do that again.
Yeah, now can they get that bad taste out of their mouth here? Now a desperation throw deep, and this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Justin Evans, and his guys are going to take over at the...